classic.
The blueberry one is the best one.
The blueberry Pop-Tart is the best Pop-Tart?
No.
Hold on.
Plain strawberry Pop-Tarts are the best Pop-Tarts.
I... Like, without the frosting?
Mm-hmm.
Ew. Ew. Fucking yuck. I am disgusted. I want to take an SOS pad and just cleanse my skin with it.
What up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Two Guys with Raging Goals. I'm Mikey and this is Adam. And every Friday, we bring you a conversational podcast where one of us brings a topic to this table and we discuss it for your enjoyment. If you like that, you can follow us on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter at Two Guys with Raging Goals. You can follow us on patreon.com/twoguysraging. Throw us a couple bucks. I didn't do the backslash and it threw me off. Throw us a couple bucks, keep these lights on, fund our new Harry Potter series, Muggles at Large. You can also catch us on Tuesdays with Two Guys Raging Tuesdays live on Facebook. Adam goes live and yells at people and drinks bourbon. Drinking bourbon. You can catch Rage of the Days every Thursday and all kinds of other fucking shit that we do. And like we have an Instagram, it's right here.
TGRG2123. Boom! Baby. Maybe right boom, here. Baby!
I'm gonna start just putting stuff over you.
That'd be great. I love it. Hey, whoa,
whoa. All right, Adam.
Can't catch me, bro.
Fireball go past your head. All right. What is this story that you couldn't tell me?
So no, it's not even really a good story. Oh, so the build up. So the build up probably isn't gonna make this story as funny as
it was.
Okay.
You got a Starbucks today.
Is it?
Starbucks is open?
Oh, yeah.
It's the Lord's Day.
Stop it. Stop. Well, stores are usually really busy.
What
really
I mean by that is it's Easter, not just that it's Sunday.
Yeah, not just that
it's Sunday. It is double Lord's Day.
Yeah. So, the only day that Starbucks closes for is Christmas. Starbucks is usually really slow on Easter, so it's like you just cut a bunch of like people early and stuff. But yeah, and some stores actually like reduce their hours and stuff. But yeah, we're just operating like normal.
Yeah, right.
Normal Sunday.
I didn't think about it until like I was like,
which I remember when I got a job at Target and I realized that Target was closed on Easter. I thought that was weird.
Isn't it weird?
It's so weird.
I'm surprised we still do it. Like
I'm shocked that hasn't changed at all. But yeah, it was. Yeah, I thought that was. I was like, you mean there's no store that day? What?
Yeah.
What's going on? Yeah.
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 All right.
Okay.
So what's up?
Okay. So. Okay, I went to Great Clips the other day. That's where I get this fresh new haircut every like 3 weeks. Okay? Alright, but no, listen. I sat down in the chair. I realized that the
barista?
No.
Damn it, I was hoping I'd get you to say it.
Wait, barista? Do you want me to say barista?
I was gonna like you're trying to say like the hairdresser. Or something.
Yeah, yeah.
I wanted to say barista, and you go yes, the barista, and then be like,
the person who's cutting my hair. One of the people
leading you down a dark tunnel.
Yes, there's this lady who's cut my hair since I was in like middle school.
Okay,
it works for Great Clips. She had moved locations, and I found her. She worked at the Great Clips right next to Target. And then I went in this last time. I found out that she doesn't work there anymore, so I'm not going to be going there anymore. But I also found out that this other hairdresser who I like is moving to Michigan. She's talking to me. I didn't know she was pregnant, and I didn't know that she was married.
Doesn't sound like you like her very much.
But she is pregnant, and she's married. And she said that... her husband... took her son's hat, and she said that her son has a really big head.
Okay.
Took his son's hat and put it on and put the hat over his ears.
Okay, yeah.
And it was covering his ears.
Yeah.
And she was like, hey, you're not supposed to wear that hat like that. And he was like, no, I've seen people do it before. And so he argued with her and said that he was supposed to be wearing the hat over his ears. It's like a, I assume it's like a baseball cap.
Right, yeah, this isn't like a postal worker's hat.
No, it's not, yeah, it's not, yeah, it's not, no, 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 no. He's wearing a baseball cap on his head, covering the top of his ears. Like a fucking weirdo. Like
so the only people who do that are people who have ginormous ears. I have big ears and I still don't do it.
Yeah.
But like, I do know some people who have like really, like their ears push out a lot. And so like when they wear a hat, they use it to like kind of pin them in.
Yeah.
Because when you wear a hat, it naturally pushes them out even more. And so like—
then you look like you've got—
yeah, yeah. So like people with already wide ears, sometimes they'll do that to keep them pinned. But even those people know,
like, that's not how you're supposed
to do this.
Well, then she goes on to tell me that she had to get on Reddit and find
Reddit, the answer for everything.
And find, because she said that he wouldn't listen to her. And so she had, and she, and he only gets all, he gets all of his facts from Reddit.
Okay.
And so she had to find a Reddit post or a thread that explained to him—
that's amazing—
that he was misguided about his hat. And I thought it was really funny because I just imagined this guy like walking around like a fucking weirdo. Looking like he's got a big salad bowl.
Looking like a Chauncey McCormick.
Yeah, exactly.
Real douchebag.
Real big douchebag.
All right. So this week—
yes—
I want to talk about something, and like, I don't feel like this will go too long.
No.
So, you know, maybe a Krista sized episode here.
That'll be
nice perfect and digestible for her.
Oh, absolutely.
I love that we just throw shade at her all the time. She catches it like 3 weeks
later.
That
was really good on the fucking live video the other day. That was great.
Yeah.
That was great.
So I recently watched 13 Reasons Why because I hate myself.
Okay.
Because that's the only real reason to watch that, besides the fact that it's amazing.
Yeah.
But, like, you hate yourself by the time you're done watching it, and, like, there's scenes in it that are just dark.
Yeah.
Just dark.
Just, like, some bad shit.
Yeah, bad juju. Just fucking God, it's hard to watch.
Yeah.
But it's a great show.
So, are we going to talk about— we should probably explain at least the general sense of what that show's about.
Okay. I can do that. Because I love Hannah Baker, and her and I are life partners now.
So, oh, good.
That ended quickly, but—
Yeah. So we should tell them what that's all about. Then we should talk about why you like it so much.
Okay.
You know, because we're not going to give— I don't want you to give away any of, like, the middle plot or end plot.
Yeah, yeah.
But, like, the general sense of what it's about, why you love it so much, and then we'll go on with your other stuff.
Okay. I might do a review of this. I'm not sure.
Okay.
But anyways.
Three and three?
We haven't talked about that yet because, like, so time is elusive. So, like, by the time this video goes up, you might have already seen a 3 and 3 review. You also may not even know what that is because I might not have ever done it. So, like, it's hard to say. But yes, I might do a 3 and 3 on 13 Reasons Why. But okay, so 13 Reasons Why, apparently a book. I didn't know that. And I think it was like a teen book. I don't know that, but that's the vibe I've gotten from people.
Yeah.
And it was created into a Netflix original series. It's 13 episodes long. Each episode's about an hour. Maybe 45 minutes, something like that. It's basically the story of Hannah Baker. She's the main character.
Yep.
It starts out with she is dead. She has committed suicide, and she has left behind 13 tapes. And these are the 13 reasons why she— what led to her killing herself and committing suicide.
Yes.
And so what you could say is the other protagonist in this, Clay Jensen, is the person who gets the tapes.
Yes.
And so he is listening through them, and each episode has flashbacks. Did you notice, you've seen a couple episodes, so Clay in the very first episode, like, wipes out on his bicycle.
Yes.
And he gets this giant scar on his head, right?
Yes.
I guarantee you, like, I do not know this for anything, but because there's all these flashbacks and flash forwards,
that's why they did it.
Yeah, so that you can—
It's like the episode of Walking Dead in, like, season 5 or 6, when something happened and they went back to Alexandria.
Okay.
And there was, like, the episode is split into two fundamentally different things.
Yeah.
Like, one of it One, like, the present day is black and white.
Yes.
And Rick has, like, scars on his face, like, yep, with, like, bandages.
Yeah.
And then everything else is in color.
Right.
All the flashbacks
are in color. And it helps you distinguish.
Yeah. So, I was watching that, and I was like, there's no reason why he should still have a Band-Aid on his head. We're over it.
Yeah.
The whole time he's just...
Yeah, they do that so that you can easily see, like, wait, is this happening now or is this in the past?
Right.
And so, like, and it does that throughout the whole series. You go in and out, and it's essentially the 13 Reasons Why are 13 people who bullied Hannah at school one way or another.
Yes. Like,
these are the reasons why I've decided to kill myself.
Yes.
And that's kind of the whole story. And so you learn her story through these tapes, and each episode is about another individual in this high school. It's kind of your typical teen high school of, like, the jocks are popular and can do whatever they want. And,
right.
But it touches on a lot of good subject matter, I thought.
Yeah. Wholesome shit.
Well, I don't know about wholesome. It's very interesting.
Yeah.
And, like, we're both pretty far removed from high school, but, like, it was done in such a way that I could see it being realistic.
Yeah, like, it wasn't like a click. Like, they all, like, all of the different people still talked and interacted.
Right, yeah.
But there were definitely those, like, segmented groups, like, friend groups.
Yeah, and
people
so
who hung out together.
Yeah, it never felt like a typical teen movie where it's like, you have the jocks over here and the popular kids and the smart kids.
Yeah,
and the welders, and, like, yeah, it wasn't like that. So anyways, I really enjoyed that. I thought it was great. Had no idea that it was a book, and generally I'm the type of person who's like, hey, read the book, it's gonna be better. I enjoyed this, and I feel no compulsion to read the book. Like, I feel like I got everything that I wanted out of this from this, and like, it scares me because it says it's season one, and I'm like, I don't, how, like, if you do a season two, it cannot be this. Like,
it can't
be different high school, different people, different shit. Like, that's fine. Like that fucking horror show.
American Horror Story.
Yeah. I'm like, do that. Like,
I'm fine
with that.
And that'll be great. And, like, I can pick this season and this season. Yeah. Those are my favorites. And everything else is just...
So I generally liked it quite a bit.
Which is actually quite odd for you.
Yeah.
I feel like, because you don't usually like melancholy.
Yeah. The older I've gotten, the more I try to stay away from that shit. Like, just in general. Like... And not to be, like, a fucking dumbass or, like, a fucking naysayer or whatever, but, like, I just don't want to put that shit in my life. Like, there's enough bullshit in the world. Like, I want to watch funny things or things that make me laugh or, like, feel warm and fuzzy, right?
Yeah.
But, yes, this was very dark, very twisted, but very well done, I thought. I enjoyed it a lot. Side note, Hannah Baker is fucking gorgeous.
Yeah.
Also, the person who plays her is British.
Uh-oh. You know what that means?
She went, like, to the top of the list.
Yep.
It's, like, Winnie Cooper.
Yep.
Hannah Baker. Emma Watson.
Whoa.
And then Katy Perry's KJ.
Oh, like, my God. I didn't know that she was above Emma Watson.
Yeah. I love her. And she's, like, just more my type.
Yeah. Like, yeah, Emma Watson, like, she cut her hair. Yeah. She's, like,
Emma Watson's cool. She's, like, pretty thin. Right?
But she's,
like,
real beautiful.
Oh,
but
cool.
But yes.
Anyways.
Okay.
So.
Bye.
So I'm enjoying this a lot, right? And, like, I'm also someone who's generally kind of late to pop culture.
Yeah.
And I'm, like, right in the middle of this, right? Like, 13 Reasons Why is super popular right now. And I was like, oh, holy shit. Like, I actually was able to watch something, like, Making a Murderer. Oh, yeah, no, I love that show. And nobody's talking about it anymore because they all watched it 2 years ago.
Right.
So I'm like, oh, I'm, like, right in it. I'm right in the thick of it. Really have enjoyed it. Thought it was good. I see this on the internet the other day, and it spawns me to want to just start punching people.
Oh, yeah.
Small infants. Okay, so somebody I follow said this. I can give you at least 13 reasons why. 13 Reasons Why was a turd of a book and wasn't even worth the paper it was printed on, even if I only used that paper to wipe my ass. And another 13, why it didn't deserve to be made into a film, even though it was not made into a film, it was made into a series. But you just keep eating up that garbage and pretending it tastes good. So here's my problem with that.
Yes.
And, like, we'll expand outwards.
Yes.
Because Fast and Furious is my perfect example of this.
Yes.
There are two different things. If I could draw a line right here.
Yep.
You can have things you enjoy and things that are good. They don't have to be the same
thing. Well, they're a Venn diagram.
Perfect. perfectly,
right? So yeah. There aren't things that necessarily always fall on this side or this side. Sometimes they fall in the middle. Sometimes they are in both groups.
Apparently, Moby Dick is really good. Very high quality book. Like, super well written and has all these deep meanings and things. I could not enjoy that book if my life fucking depended on it.
Yes.
Like, I cannot. But apparently it's good. Like, apparently it is quality good. Similarly, Fast and the Furious. Never gonna win any Oscars.
Right.
Not necessarily maybe quality movies. Maybe not good cinema.
Yeah. Maybe not good storytelling.
Yeah. But I fucking love them. Yes. I enjoy the shit out of them.
Mm-hmm.
And that's okay. And so when I saw this about 13 Reasons Why, not only did it upset me because I feel like 13 Reasons Why falls right in the middle of this, of like, this was really well done, and I thoroughly fucking enjoyed it.
Yeah.
The soundtrack to 13 Reasons Why, like, I don't even know, like, I just realized it as I was watching. It was like, they have great music playing through all of this. Like, I don't know any of the songs or anything, but like, it just, like, it is one of those things. Yeah. Like, it totally fits what's happening in the moment. Like, they did a really good job with that.
Hmm.
And so, like, there were, and like the way they did flashbacks and stuff and like all that stuff, I was like, they did a really good job. And like the story arc, and like, I was like, yeah, this is like quality. Plus, I enjoyed the characters. I enjoyed what they talked about. Like, I found myself wanting to go back, because like every episode would end and you'd be like, who's on the tape? You know, like,
yeah.
So they did a good job of that. And so like, I loved it. And then I see something like this and I'm like, my immediate reaction was, who the fuck are you? Like, yeah. To tell me what I'm allowed to enjoy.
Yeah, so there's something very pretentious about it.
So and pretentious.
So I'm going through kind of a similar thing in my life where, and this only slightly applies, but I have come to this crossroads in my life where, like, politically. Right.
At the crossroads.
My God, stop it. But politically, I'm at a crossroads, right? Yeah. And I'm realizing that, like, okay, there are things that I believe in, and then there are things that other people believe in, and I've got to listen to those things. If not, because I will, like, even if I won't agree with them, I got to listen to them so that I know what their issues are.
Right.
So that I can maybe think about my, like, consider things. Think about things, maybe convince someone otherwise to the contrary, bring them with me, you know, that sort of thing. And so I've been doing that. And so to me, when people say, like, shut it down, it's stupid, I don't want to hear it, like, it bothers me, because, like, you are so uninformed when you do things like that.
Yeah.
When you don't listen to other people or share ideas, you are so uninformed and you are so ingenuine. That is another thing that really fucking drives me nuts. Gets me going.
Gets me grinding my ears.
Seriously?
Yeah.
It's like, when people are so turned off to something that they will not listen, or if they have an idea, they refuse to share it. It is ingenuine.
Yeah.
To be that kind of person.
And I think, like, I don't understand why people, like, what makes you feel so superior that you can tell somebody what they enjoy? Because, like, I think the Kardashians are stupid, right?
Yeah.
Like, I think reality TV in general is stupid. I was talking to somebody about this the other day. They love Big Brother. And I could see myself actually liking the show, the premise of it and everything. Like, I get sucked.
It's very strategic. Yeah.
Totally could see myself doing that. But I know that I don't have time for it, and B, like, I bet this is real stupid and full of drama and fucking goddammit, I'm never gonna watch this. But I'm not gonna tell you you can't enjoy that.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not gonna tell you you're real dumb for enjoying this.
That'd be like, so this is the issue, right? And one of the things that I would challenge someone to think about is, like, okay, sports. Do I like sports? There are some sports that I like. I'll watch.
What sports?
I mean, I'll watch football. I will watch a football game.
Oh, like a Raiders game?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
I will watch that.
Yep.
I will do that.
I was trying to think of when you've ever talked to me about sports. That's why Raiders came up. Raiders.
So I will do it.
Yeah.
I don't spend every weekend doing it, but I understand it.
Yeah.
I understand the rules, the context. I understand it. And I understand why people would be passionate about it.
Yep.
Maybe it's like a tribalism thing. Maybe it's like a thing where, like, I came from this place. My family came from this place. Yeah. I really like that city, and that team represents that, you know?
Yep.
At the end of the season, you've got a big championship. Yep. Whatever the sport is, big championship, teams going up against
Penguins
each other.
Penguins playing right now. We're 2-0.
What the fuck? It doesn't matter who wins the championship.
Right. Because it doesn't change anything.
Because next year, we're going to do it again.
Yeah. Yeah.
Are sports stupid then?
Right, exactly.
No, they're not.
Exactly.
They are just something you don't want to partake in.
Yep.
Right? And, like, that's fine. That doesn't make it stupid.
Yeah. And that's, like, so when I read this, I was like, you know, I know this person and I know 100 things that they're into that I think is really dumb. Like, it's just fucking retarded, and all I have to do is scroll through your Facebook to see the things that I think you do that are fucking dumb.
Yeah.
But I'm never going to, like, when you post something about some fucking band you like or some other stupidity, fucking food that you like.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I'm not going to post on there and be like, you know, you shouldn't eat all those carbs. It's not good for you. You should, like,
yeah.
No, like,
no, this is not my platform to educate you or change your mind about this. Like, It is just a sharing of ideas.
Yeah. Nobody reached out to you and, like, I didn't read this as, like, a comment on a 13 Reasons Why thread or something.
Right.
Or somebody commented about it and then she commented or he commented.
Yeah.
Like, nobody fucking did that. This person just fucking put it as their status and put it out there. And I'm like,
nobody asked you.
Nobody asked you. And so what you are doing is coming from a very negative place.
Yeah,
it's coming from a, like, I'm going to fuck. I'm smarter than you,
and I am looking for confrontation.
Yep,
and challenge me.
Yeah,
and fucking challenge me.
It's like, why would you do that? Like, just like in the example of, like, you post some food that's, like, super bad for you. You didn't come to me and say, like, hey, Mikey, like, what do you think about this? Like, would this be a good idea to eat?
And you're not a pop culture social critic.
Yeah.
So, like, nobody is. No one is going to you and looking for this type of content.
My friend told me, when that person writes a fucking book, maybe then they can give their comments. But until then, I don't give a fuck.
Like,
oh, that's smart.
Yeah, no, that's very true, right? Yeah. And that's why, like, I feel like we can comment on this because we put this shit out into the universe.
Yeah.
And it's like, hey, like it or lump it.
Yeah.
Right? It's out there, and we're just sharing our ideas.
Yeah.
So when we comment on something, it's okay because we're putting ourselves out there. But as soon as somebody came back and had a contrary opinion to that, that person would lose their fucking mind.
Right.
There could be people. That person could find this episode and repost it and be like, these people are fucking bastards. They're talking shit. They're subtweeting. They stole. And I'd be like,
time out. There's a B.
What?
Okay, where? It's gone.
Is it there?
No, it's gone.
Was it over there, though?
It flew in the window, but then it went back out.
Oh,
okay. Guys, I don't like bees.
Just chill.
I don't like bees. I use him as a fucking human shield. I will fucking throw bees through the glass to fucking stop this fucking bee. Like, there is nothing safe in this room at this point.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, and like that's my problem is, like, when you put something out there just to be an asshole, just to fucking talk shit.
Yeah.
And judge people. What good are you doing in the world?
Well, so everybody who's... You watched a few episodes with us, I hope.
At least one or two if you found this one probably.
So you know how I feel about freedom of speech, right? So, like, you can freely talk about all of the bullshit you want to. Freely talk about it. But you have to understand that as soon as you put those thoughts out there, other people have the freedom to then backlash.
Right, to comment on it and say whatever
they
want.
So if you put it out there and you say that, you are opening the door for people to say some negative shit about your negative fucking thoughts.
Yeah.
So, just be open and ready for that.
Yeah.
Be okay with that. And I guarantee that person would not be okay with
that.
Or would have absolutely no realm of thought around, like, having a civil discussion.
Yeah, no.
At all.
No.
And then, and they like surround themselves with this. And this is why I fucking hate this echo chamber that fucking happens on the internet.
Oh, yeah.
That person, he or she, surrounds themselves with people who are very like weird and like-minded.
Right. Like they think they are smarter than each other, and like
and so they have this big circle jerk, and they're like this is how it is, fucking yeah,
right.
No, and it's not like that. What it actually is like is we live in reality. And different people think differently about different things, especially things that are review and opinion based.
Yeah.
Versus you just being an outright stupid jackass about your opinion about a book or a show based on a book that you have read. I am not convinced.
Yeah, no, me neither.
And a show that you have watched. Maybe? Question
mark? Yeah.
Probably not. Probably none of those things. But because it's not Thoreau, you've got a lot of fucking opinions about it.
Yeah. And that's why I need to like cut that and throw that on Instagram.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
That's my last comment on this will be, you can have like what you enjoy is subjective.
Yes.
And so we cannot have objective conversations about those things.
Yes.
I cannot tell you, enjoying Power Rangers is dumb for these reasons, Adam.
Yes.
Because it doesn't fucking matter. What you like is what you like. Yes. And it's like, it's a personal thing. It's subjective. What you like, I may not like, and vice versa.
Yes. Don't try to impede on my life with your shit exactly. either.
Yeah, don't bring your fucking baggage to what
yeah, don't
I
be,
like.
Yeah, don't be like... Oh, well, yeah, like, don't do that. Or if it's like, you know that you love B-movies, don't fill my home with B-movies. Because you will have to find a small one-bedroom apartment and then lose your job. but yes, okay, keep going.
So that is subjective. We can have an objective conversation about the quality of something, right? Of saying, absolutely. Like... Does this meet certain standards by good cinema or a good
book? If it's a book, does it have a beginning, middle, and end?
Yeah, like...
Is the writing up to par? Yeah. Like, are there run-on sentences? Are there, like, are we just perpetuating bullshit?
You can talk about a good example of this is episode one, The Phantom Menace.
Yes.
It always sticks out to me that while a lot of people enjoyed that movie has no protagonist. None.
No.
There is no
it is trying to focus on three different things all at once.
It is nobody's story.
You've got your Jedi, you've got Jar Jar Binks, and then you got Anakin fucking flying a fucking ship that he stole as a 7-year-old.
Like, you have Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan doing their thing, and like they find Anakin, but Anakin's clearly not the main character. And then it's Padme's fucking planet that's being taken over, but she's not a main character. And so, like, there is no actual protagonist throughout this whole movie. Like, you can argue Obi-Wan is, but it clearly wasn't meant
to be. Well, it makes... the last thing I have to say about Phantom Menace, you should have never brought this up. But the whole movie is a middle.
Yeah.
The whole movie's a middle.
Yeah. Yeah.
It is the middle of the book. You are dropped in. You are in the middle. And you never get out. There's a parade to represent the end, but you're just in the middle.
Right. And that's like... And so you can argue these things, right? I love Star Wars, and I'll ride or die with the prequels, even though mostly it's dying. But I can objectively say, like, for these reasons, it's not a good story.
Right.
It's not a great movie. They shot all of this one in CG, and that makes it hard to fucking feel grounded in this. Those are objective things that you can say. You cannot fucking tell somebody what they are allowed to enjoy.
Yes.
Like, you can't. Like, I can tell you can't enjoy murder because, like, we have societal rules that say, like, okay, that's cool that's what you're into, but you're going to have to stay in prison.
Yeah.
Like, that's where you can stay.
Yeah.
Because as society, we've decided you're not allowed to do those things.
Yes.
But, like, in general, you cannot tell somebody what content they're allowed to enjoy or not. Like, mm-hmm. like, even people who are into fucking weird shit, like, you cannot tell them you can't like that. You can tell them it is not acceptable to be into these things.
Yes.
It is not acceptable.
Maybe it's not a social norm.
Yeah. But, like, again, you cannot tell that person, stop liking that.
Yeah.
Like, that's never good. That A, it'll never work, and B, it's not okay.
It, yeah, right? And it's this preconceived notion, and it's you know what it is? You know what it is, Mike?
Oh,
I'll tell you something, Mike. What it is it's fucking pompous and bullshit.
Yeah, it is.
Pompous bullshit.
Guys, thank you so much for tuning in. If you enjoyed this, hit the little thing with the thing and subscribe to us on YouTube.
You're there.
Share.
This.
Like our shit.
That. Yeah.
All the new content that we're doing, you guys, we're cranking out all kinds of shit right now. Adam's maybe or not flooded Instagram with a bunch of photos that he's taking now.
Yeah.
Go like that shit. Follow us on all of our platforms. You can follow us on iTunes, anywhere that podcasts are available to get audio versions, except for one of the last ones. I forgot to fucking do it yet, but I'll do it. Thank you so much, you guys, and we will catch you on the next one.
Oh, perfect.
So that first one I might cut up into two different videos, and I'll just chop